Hello students, in this video we are going to talk about the types of chemical reactions. See, there are so many types of chemical reactions, but in class 10 there are some basic type of chemical reaction that you can see over here. The first one is combination reaction, or it is also known as synthesis reaction. The second one is decomposition reaction, that is you can call it analysis reaction. Third one is single displacement reaction or substitution reaction. Fourth one is double displacement or metathesis reaction, and the fifth one is oxidation reduction, or you can generally call it redox reaction. So in this video I am going to discuss about the first one is combination reaction. You can see combination reaction. See, combination reaction, its general formula is A plus B, and they combine with each other and they form AB. So the key point of this type of reaction is they form a single product. Okay, single product. We can take an example as well, like CaO plus H2O, and they form CaOH twice as a single product. This is calcium oxide, it is also known as quicklime. This is water, and this is calcium hydroxide, it is also known as slaked lime. Okay, so you can see over here two compounds. Actually the definition of this type of reaction is when two or more than two compounds combine with each other and they form a single product, then such type of reaction are known as combination reaction. Okay, so these two compounds combining and they are forming a single product. We can take another example as well, like burning of coal. C plus O2, CO2. Okay, this is solid, this is gaseous form, and this is also gaseous form. And the second example is the formation of water. Formation of water, you can see H2, the reaction is H2 plus O2, and they are forming H2O. You can balance it by adding these coefficients. Okay, so these are the examples of combination reaction, and now we will talk about this compound calcium hydroxide. Actually, this calcium hydroxide is used for whitewashing the walls. Okay, after whitewashing, after 2 or 3 days, it reacts with carbon dioxide which is present in the air and form a thin layer of calcium carbonate CaCO3 and H2O. Okay, so this thin layer of calcium carbonate gives a shiny finish to the wall. So this compound is responsible for that. Actually, the formula of marble is also, chemical formula of marble is also CaCO3. It is very interesting. Okay, so, and one thing more we can notice, that in combination reaction, like if I talk about the burning of coal, C plus O2 is equal to CO2. This is a combination reaction, and you can see that in such type of reaction heat is evolved along with the formation of the products. So because heat is evolved here along with the formation of products, so that means combination reactions are generally exothermic reactions. So combination reaction are exothermic in nature. You can say like that. Okay, now we will talk about the decomposition reaction. See, decomposition is the second type of chemical reactions. Its general formula will be AB, and it splits up into its components A plus B. So you can see it is the opposite of the combination reaction. So we can take an example as well, like FeSO4. If we give some activation energy as heat, then it breaks down into its simpler components, simpler substance. Fe2O3 ferric oxide, this is ferrous sulfate, and Fe2O3 ferric oxide plus CO2 plus SO2 and plus SO3, sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide, you can see. Another example you can take, like PbNO3 twice, and after giving some activation energy, it decomposes into its simpler substances, like lead oxide plus NO2 plus oxygen. You can balance it by adding these coefficients 2, 2 and this 4 over here. You can also balance it like this, Fe2O3 3 to 5 and 5, 3, 8, 4 to the 8 oxygen is here, 2 sulfur, 2 sulfur, okay. So, these equations are balanced, and these are the examples of decomposition reaction, you can see. In this type of reaction, a complex compound splits up into its simpler substances, okay. So, AB arrow A plus B. So, this is the general formula of decomposition reaction. And you can notice that for these type of reaction, heat is needed, okay. The activation energy is needed, like in the form of heat, it could be in the form of sunlight as well. Like example, if I take, so this is AgCl, silver chloride, if we put it in sunlight, it has some sensitivity to sunlight, so it breaks down into silver and chlorine, okay. So, this type of decomposition is known as photo decomposition, and these type of reactions are need some heat, so these are known as thermal decomposition. Another example of photo decomposition is, you can take silver bromide as well. So, after putting it in sunlight, it also broken down into silver and bromine, okay. So, you can see like that. So, silver bromide is actually used in photography, okay, for the photography plates, and there is an example of electric decomposition as well. Like if you talk about H2O, then we can separate hydrogen and oxygen from this water molecule by the process of electrolysis, okay. So, this type of decomposition is known as electric decomposition. So, we have studied about three types of decomposition in this lecture, that is thermal decomposition, photo decomposition and electric decomposition. Now, we will talk about single displacement reaction. You can see single displacement reaction is the third type of chemical reactions, single displacement reaction. Third type, okay. Its general formula is A plus BC arrow AP AC plus B. Such type of reaction in which a more reactive elements takes the place or displaces a less reactive element from its compound. Such type of reaction are known as single displacement. We can take an example as well. If I write Fe plus CuSO4, then this Fe takes the place of copper from its compound. So, it will be, the product will be FeSO4 plus Cu, okay. You can take another example like Zn plus CuSO4, and they form ZnSO4 plus Cu. Actually, these are more reactive, that is why these are taking the place of these less reactive elements, and we can find it by the reactivity series, that is this is the reactivity series. Okay, you can see over here potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, lead, hydrogen, copper, mercury, silver and platinum. So you can see this is the reactivity series and this arrow shows the reactivity order. That means platinum is the least reactive and potassium is the most reactive element or substance. Okay, so you can see here iron and here is copper. So in this reaction you can see iron is displacing or replacing the copper. So that means iron is above than copper, that means iron is more reactive than copper. Okay, and Zn, okay, you can see zinc is also more reactive than copper. So that is why these substances can replace this copper from its compound, and this is why we can call it single displacement reaction. Okay, now we will talk about double displacement reaction. The fourth one is double displacement reaction. So double displacement reaction, the general formula is AB plus CD arrow. You can assume like that inner substances combined with each other and the outer substances combined with each other. So it will be BC plus BC plus AD. Okay, so that means those type of chemical reaction in which two substances or two positive ions interchange with each other, interchange. Okay, so these are known as double displacement reaction. We can take an example as well, like if I write Na2SO4 plus BaCl2, they form BaSO4 plus NaCl. We can balance it by adding this coefficient here. Okay, so that means you can see sodium is taking the place of barium and barium is taking place of the sodium and forming these compounds. Okay, so you can tell this is a double displacement reaction. Okay, now let's move on the last one, the oxidation reduction reaction. The last one is oxidation and reduction reaction. Okay, oxidation reduction reaction, or generally it is also known as redox reaction. Earlier we know that gain of oxygen or loss of hydrogen is called oxidation. I can write here as oxidation means gain of oxygen or loss of hydrogen, and in the case of reduction it will be its opposite, like loss of oxygen, okay, and gain of hydrogen. But these days we know that the transfer of electrons, it is also responsible for this oxidation reduction reaction. We can assume that where is oxidation and where is reduction reaction, but in class 10 we will follow only these rules. Okay, and the example is if I write Cu plus H2O and they form CuO plus CuO plus H2 and they form H2O plus Cu. Okay, now you can see here H2 to H2O, that means gain of oxygen. So it is oxidation. And here you can see Cu to CuO to Cu, that means loss of oxygen. So it will be reduction. Okay, so in my next video I'll talk about oxidation reduction reaction on the basis of electron transfer. So this is all about the five types of chemical reaction that is given in class 10 syllabus. Thank you.